Professor Dave here. Let's go 3D.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
All throughout this math series, we've been working with the coordinate plane, which has perpendicular x and y axes. But this represents only two spatial dimensions. Sometimes we will want to do math involving the third spatial dimension that we experience every day. For this reason, it will be useful to learn the basics regarding three-dimensional coordinate systems. Let's start with the coordinate plane and its two axes. In order to generate a three-dimensional space, we simply have to add a third axis, a z-axis, which is perpendicular to the plane containing the x and y axes. And with that, we've gone from a two-dimensional plane to a three-dimensional space. Whereas a point on a plane can be described with an ordered pair, the first number giving the x-coordinate and the second number giving the y-coordinate, in space, we will need an ordered triple, where three numbers give us the x, y, and z coordinates of the point. Convention requires that the three axes must be oriented in a particular way, and this way is given by the right-hand rule. This tells us that if you have the three axes, but you want to determine which direction on each axis is positive or negative, simply curl your hand around the z-axis. If your fingers are curling from the positive side of the x-axis and towards the positive side of the y-axis in counterclockwise fashion, then your thumb is pointing in the positive direction of the z-axis. With these axes all set, there is a lot to identify in this new space. First, there are now three coordinate planes instead of one. Those are the xy, xz, and yz planes, which each contain the two axes listed. Then, instead of the coordinate plane, which has quadrants, space is divided up into eight octants, with the first octant being the one where x, y, and z values are all positive. So any point in space will have three coordinates. It can be a little tricky to represent these three dimensions in the two dimensions of a screen or piece of paper. But if we draw lines or even a box, it usually becomes possible to visualize it. In addition, whereas assigning a constant value to one of these variables would produce a line in the two-dimensional coordinate plane, doing so in three-dimensional space will produce a plane. The intersection of two planes, so long as they are not parallel, will give us a line, and there are a number of ways a line can be represented algebraically, including with vectors, which we will get to in a moment. One thing we should be aware of is that just the way we can find the distance between two points in the coordinate plane by using the distance formula, we can do the same thing in three-dimensional space. And the analogous formula for three dimensions will not be very surprising if you remember the old one. If we have two points, P1 and P2, both with x, y, and z coordinates, we can draw a box whereby the two points are opposite corners of the box, and the diagonal of the box connects them. The length of this line segment, or the distance between the two points, will be given by this equation, with x2 minus x1 quantity squared, plus y2 minus y1 quantity squared, plus z2 minus z1 quantity squared, all under a square root. So all we have done to the original distance formula is added this z term. We can arrive at this formula simply by drawing triangles within the box and applying the Pythagorean theorem. Let's call these two points A and B. P1, P2 quantity squared is equal to P1B quantity squared plus BP2 quantity squared. P1B quantity squared, in turn, is equal to P1A quantity squared plus AB quantity squared. So we can make that substitution now. Well, P1A is just the difference in the x-coordinates. AB is the difference in the y-coordinates. And BP2 is the difference in the z-coordinates, so let's represent them that way, and take the square root of both sides. That's how we get this distance formula. Let's apply the formula and get the distance between the point 2, negative 1, 7, and the point 1, negative 3, 5. All we have to do is plug these numbers into the formula, evaluate each difference, square the resulting values, add those numbers together, and take the square root. So 3 will be our answer. Now that we know how to use three-dimensional coordinates, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.